The year was 2000. 5 years had passed since the completion of the legendary manga known as Dragon Ball, written by mangaka Akira Toriyama. It was the turn of the century and the turn of the millennium. And during this particular year, Akira Toriyama worked on a brand new manga, which on May 9, 2000 began releasing in Weekly Shonen Jump. That manga was called Sandland. Now, Sandland was a relatively short story, only running for about 14 chapters and serializing Weekly Shonen Jump from May 9th, 2000 until August 8th, 2000, until becoming a fully-fledged manga on November 2nd in the year 2000. The story had a lot of classic Akira Toriyama elements that you would find in Dragon Ball, such as action, adventure, heart, and of course, plenty of humor. While it never quite reached the highs that Dragon Ball ever did, it was still a relatively successful manga, and those who read it around the time very much enjoyed it. I myself did not read it at the time because I was 3 years old when it came out. Give me a break. It featured the demon prince Beelzebub, a little demon gremlin named Thief, and a human sheriff named Rao traveling the desert known only as Sandland, fighting and stealing from the rich, giving to the poor, and helping anyone that they find along their way. All in an effort to find a mysterious spring that had a huge supply of water for everyone to enjoy, all while having to deal with the tyrannical rule of a king that ruled over the Sandland. But as time passed, the knowledge of Sandland faded into relative obscurity, as very few people in the West, at least, knew about it. Fast forward 23 years, and Sandland came back. Following the completion and the success of Dragon Ball Super, Toei Animation decided to make a proper Sandland anime adaptation. And so, in August of 2023, they decided to make Sandland the movie, an hour and 46 minute long movie that retold the story of Sandland relatively faithfully. And of course, being who he was, Akira Toriyama acted as a huge supervisor in Sandland, making sure that the movie stayed faithful to the manga. And like the manga itself, it never reached the highs that Dragon Ball did. However, it still enjoyed moderate success, and following the success of the Sandland movie, it was announced that Sandland would get a video game adaptation in 2024. And that video game, I had no plans of ever playing. For as much as I enjoyed Sandland, I didn't find the idea of a Sandland video game particularly enticing. Nothing really grabbed my attention to the degrees of, say, certain Pokemon fan games, Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door, Shin Megami Tensei 5 Vengeance. However, on March 8th, 2024, the world was turned upside down when we were informed that a week prior, on March 1st, 2024, series mangaka Akira Toriyama had tragically passed away due to a brain hemorrhage. It was a devastating loss for many people, especially because of the immense impact that not only he had from the story Dragon Ball, but the impact that he had on other amazing mangaka that created some of the greatest stories that people have ever read or seen on television. People gathered from all over the world, doing everything that they could to celebrate the life of Akira Toriyama, giving thanks to everything that he did in order to be sure that his memory and legacy would not be forgotten. As for me, I didn't do much at first. I obviously was upset, just like everybody else, but I was also in the middle of working on other projects and didn't have a proper opportunity to give Akira Toriyama my respect and praise. But the time for excuses is over, and I think it's fair that I put my foot down and experience one of the last things that Akira Toriyama had any involvement in prior to his death. And so, our next Let's Play is Sandland. Hope y'all look forward to it.